welcome my guests at this time, Scotty Mac, Adonis, and the returning Erik Strange. Do you guys have a name tonight?
Well, I mean, we're Beauty and the Build, so we could be like Beauty and the Beards.
Ooh,
that doesn't matter what our name is.
What does matter is that we kick their fucking asses. And Icky, whew, things are gonna get sticky.
How do you feel about tagging with them? The last time we saw you in the same ring, I think they were responsible for your injury.
Well, how I always say, strange things happen, and if I can trust these guys, that would be a hell of a team.
You're damn right it's a hell of a team, and it's ECCW's 23rd anniversary, and tonight, we got Moonshine Mafia's number. No doubt about it.
Let's go back to ringside.
I met Michelle Starr about 20 years ago, just a few blocks up the road at the Eagles Hall. The Eagles Hall, the home of Extreme Canadian Championship Wrestling, and I honestly didn't know what to think of Michelle Starr the first time I met him. He was all blood, all guts, and yet through it all, he had a pink star over his eyes. The next time, the next few years, I saw him win all of the titles in ECCW, the tag team title, the hardcore title, the ECCW title, and we could talk about that. We could talk about him going to the United Kingdom and Japan and Korea, but I think more important, as the ECCW Trailblazer Award recipient, is his lasting legacy on professional wrestling in British Columbia. Because if you are a wrestler that has been in the back over the last 23 years in British Columbia, it doesn't matter what promotion, you were either broken into this business by gorgeous Michelle Starr, or he broke into whoever broke you into this business. His legacy will live on. He is the reason all of us are here tonight after 23 years. I said it in that video, ECCW was built on the back of this man. Would you please welcome the first recipient of the ECCW Trailblazer Award? The one, the only, the legend, gorgeous Michelle Starr!
Thank you.
I give you gorgeous Michelle Starr.
Well, you know, I tried to watch the video. When I saw my partner, lover boy Johnny, come up on the screen, it broke me up. I thought I'd stay strong tonight. I thought I'd keep my composure. But missing lover boy Johnny was one of the hardest things that I've gone through in my life. 23 years ago, it was myself, Terry Joe Silverspoon, and Johnny Canuck, who created Extreme Canadian Championship Wrestling right here in New Westminster. We were later joined by my longtime partner, Mr. Dave Republic. We went on to be one of the most dominant companies in Canada, running not just once a month, not just twice a month, but 100 shows a year. Yeah. Our best years, I was around, was 1988, 99, 2000, up to 2003. You saw some of the biggest superstars in the world here. You saw Sabu. You saw Steve Corino. Yeah! You saw the innovator of Irish Tommy Dreamer. Yeah! And you saw the one and only Juggernaut. Yeah! Now, New Westminster is very special to me because not only did I give a lot of sweat, but I bled buckets here in New Westminster, right here on Columbia Street, every week, right here. I poured blood. I did barbed wire matches. I did thumbtack matches. I did hardcore matches. I did matches I didn't think I'd walk away from. And I'm very proud to see, after I left ECCW, how it's continued on. Scotty Mack and the Natural have done a great job continuing the ECCW tradition. In 1996, myself and Johnny and Terry Joe Silverspoon thought that wrestling needed a change. It needed a spark. We needed to take this territory hardcore and take it to the extreme, and we did. Now, wow. As a lot of people have to thank here, you know, not only is the ECCW's 23rd anniversary, in just less than 2 weeks, it's on my wife and I's 30th for the anniversary. My wife and my kids have stuck by me for this whole time, for the good times, through the bad times, and there's been lots of bad times for sure. And I'm just happy to say that it's been a great marriage here on June 10th. It's gonna be 30 years. That's right. I guess somebody else needs some recognition here too. There was a lady who used to get ECCW. She worked her ass off. She worked hard. I feel that she needs a thank you too, is Mary Diaz. Yeah! I also cannot forget the tag to thank my last tag team partner, my best friend, my partner at work, my partner in All-Star Wrestling, Mr. Disco Fury. Yeah. And of course, this lovely family, the Burke family, they have stood by me from day one, and it's been amazing. Now, as many of you know or don't know, I started wrestling in 1987, way before most of these kids who were ever born. I'm the old guy. Yesterday, I celebrated my 51st birthday, and I'm still alive. Like many of these kids here, I started wrestling when I was 18 years old. In fact, there's a kid in the main event here tonight that came to my wrestling school when he was 16 years old. I had to get his mom to sign a waiver along the train, and hands down, He is the best wrestler in the Pacific Northwest today. Yeah. That is Artemis Spencer. Training lots of guys. I wasn't the complete trainer for all of them, but I had a hand in starting a career. Some of you see him on the TV right now. Gervin Hart, the Bollywood Lions. Mr. Kyle O'Reilly. Yeah. And many others. My career is over. My career ended 18 months ago in the Anvil, British Columbia. I had my last match against this man, and I'm looking forward to actually seeing him in the ring tonight. He wrestled about 18 minutes.
Wrestling personified.
In NFL, I think somebody just crashed the party.
What is this? How disrespectful is this?
Grace, that's the presence of the Moonshine Mafia. Look at the hardware. The award-winning Eli Zern and the Pacific Cup winner, Judas Icarus.
Judas is the Pacific Cup winner, but Eli Sir, that is not his award.
Why is it? He's got it in his hand. Of course, he's always joined by the natural. It's the brute of the brute, the former Canadian champion.
Michelle Starr might want to get out of the ring, being surrounded by the mafia.
My moment, not yours. Your moment, sir, was 18 months ago when I put you out to pasture. And all these people in here are drying their eyes after that sloppy speech, but me, I'm tired of this. This is my ring now. This is the Moonshine Mafia's ring now. And you know what? This man right here, my manager, the manager of managers, the natural, has done more.
Getting a hold of that Pacific Cup. Eddie Osbourne takes Strange and Scotty back down, but he gets upended by Adonis. And it looks like the rebuilt Beauty and the Builds are standing strong right now. As the natural gets his boys together on the outside.
Trying to regroup outside. I mean.
Well, this is what happens when Eli Sorge tries to get another award. Now don't touch that.
Can I look at that at least?
You look through it.
Well, oh, it's nice and shiny.
That's the award-winning Eli Sir.
Michelle Starr has a real award. Okay? Eli Sir is not.
Well, you don't think Eli Sir is trailblazer?
Not by a long shot.
Strange! Big ovation for the returning Erik Strange.
He's got deep heart for 209 pounds from a place so high, it must be the sky. Adonis! finally, ladies and gentlemen, 189 pounds from British Columbia, Scotty!
Thunderous ovation for Scotty Mack. Boy, is this one going to be intense or what?
Beauty and the Bills teaming up with Erik Strange. Maybe they should just call them the Builds. I mean, look at how jacked these three guys are. But the first time they've been teaming up, Moonshine Mafia has been a cohesive unit for over a year.
And you got to remember, too, Strange has been out for about a year with an injury that he sustained in a match against Scotty Mack.
Yes, ironically, his tag team partner tonight.
Now, don't drink that, Al.
There's no more left. He drank it all.
There's no more substance. What a jerk.
Well, what a surprise. He doesn't like you.
Well, he doesn't like anybody.
The glass is empty, but it still smells.
There's some residue in there.
Moonshine residue. Yeah, just...
Moonshine residue. There's enough for a shot.
You feel free to take it. Oh, look at Erik Strange. Looks like he hasn't beat that.
Oh, easy for you to say that he hasn't missed a beat.
Hasn't missed a beat.
Look at this from Strange.
Wow, let's get Strange. Things are about to get Strange tonight.
And if you're unfamiliar with Erik Strange, this is certainly what he can bring to the table. But you got to take into the ring rust. The nerves have got to be getting to him.
Ironically, if you listen to the ECCW podcast, The Natural actually states that Erik Strange is probably one of the most athletically gifted wrestlers in ECCW history.
Oh, I think that's undeniable.
Just look at the moves that he brings.
I mean, he's not wearing rubber boots like Eli Surge. Whoa! Deck drop.
3D there. Now Eli Surge about to rock the razor's edge, perhaps.
It's a full moon tonight, Al.
We got moonshine, we got full moon.
But Adonis may have bit off a little bit more than he can chew there.
Everybody home there. Perhaps we call that the double moonsault.
Well, uh-oh.
Oh, rolls him up.
One. Longest two count in Eli Surge's career.
Wow! Hits the moonsault.
Unbelievable athleticism from Adonis, and here comes Scotty Mack, the most decorated athlete in all of the Pacific Northwest.
A match that we were supposed to see at Ballroom Brawl 11, it all started out with a dream by Eli Surge. And now culminating all these months.
Looks like Eli's being taken to the woodshed right now.
Beauty, the Builds, and the Moonshine Mafia finally squaring off. Eli Surge, smart enough to roll out of the way. That flying forearm from the mid rope from Scotty Mack.
I think that's the first time that smart has ever been used in a sentence with Eli Surge. Up and over, and Surge, boom.
Silent land hard.
Drops, and so does Icarus.
There goes the Pacific Cup champion.
But Erik,
watch out
the big
behind
boy.
You.
Scotty Mack got a little distracted with the natural.
EO from behind. Was there a tag there? Referee making the count.
Well, maybe it's the lucha rules again. I don't know. There goes Osbourne out. Eddie Osbourne and Eli Surge going to work on Scotty Mack. And Judas Icarus!
Oh, triple team maneuver. What a splash. Down goes Scotty Mack. They get Eli Surge an extension cord. Judas Icarus is like a...
Very rabid dog aggressive. In there, all over Scotty.
Here comes a former Canadian champion, E.O. Eddie Osbourne.
Wrestling personified. he's going to work right now on a lone Scotty Mack. Not often you see him just kind of ball to the state. Heavy hitting offense from Osbourne.
In that rear chin lock. Eli Serge still looking for his belt.
Well, this is a wear down hold right now from Osbourne. He's making sure that Scotty Mack exerts a lot of energy to get back on his feet. Well, Osbourne really just has to make sure he keeps Scotty Mack down, but he can't do it as Scotty Mack fights back to a vertical base. Oh!
Running knee by the luck. The 6 or 8 pack of Scotty Mack, but he still goes down.
Just as soon as Scotty Mack goes up, the Moonshine Mafia makes sure he goes right back down. Now we got Eli Serve
using tape,
taping himself up.
I don't know if that's legal, but
well, he is a country boy.
I guess duct tape does solve everything.
Eli Serve must be a red-green
fan. He's back in it with that duct tape belt.
Well, it's not quite a championship belt, but hey, you take what you can get. Scotty Mack's been in the ring way, way too long, and he is taking the brunt of the offense here against the Moonshine Mafia.
This is for you!
Osbourne, big splash. But no, doesn't even go for the cover, picks him back up.
Well, they said that one was from Michelle Starr. Osbourne retired Starr just a few short weeks ago. And now he's in there with one of the greats. Tag.
Osbourne tags in Serge.
Moonshine Mafia effectively cut the ring in half, Al.
Well, that's what I was talking about. A cohesive unit, they've been a team for over a year. That's a big leg drop, but Scotty Mack gets out of the way. Low drop kick right on the face of Serge.
One.
Scotty Mack, I don't know if he was going for a pin there or just trying to go for a tag.
He was just trying to get to his corner by any means necessary.
Still got cut off by our Pacific Cup champion, Icarus.
Icarus. Making sure he's doing what he can do to help his team. Pulling Scotty Mack into their corner.
Serge with a scoop slam. Slams Scotty Mack down hard. Adonis is down. Erik Strange is jocking to get in the ring. What is Serge doing? Is he going to go for a high-risk move with that duct tape belt? I don't know if that's a good idea. Those boots.
Rubber boots and a rubber belt and a rubber brain.
Goodness.
Eli Serge went for it all and paid for it as he is writhing in pain, much to the chagrin of the natural.
A lot of moonsaults here tonight, but that was not effective. Luckily, he's close to making a tag. So, same with Scotty Mack.
Scotty Mack is fingertips away from Erik Strange. Judas Icarus gets the tag, and here comes Strange. It's Strange and Icarus.
What a kick. Right to the chest, another one.
Boom!
Erik Strange perhaps still having knee problems, hopefully. Did he come back too soon? We don't know.
I don't think Icarus caught all of that one. But he certainly was caught by that. Turned him inside out.
Flip, flop, and fly. There goes Icarus. Let's get Strange here at the 23rd anniversary of ECCW. Erik Strange and Irish with that reverse. Oh man, one leap to the top rope, unbelievable. Gonna go for a dragon suplex, no.
And then right to the knee.
Oh man, that knee, I don't know if it's 100%, he keeps clutching onto it.
Well, you saw that Icarus at least had the presence of mind to realize that Strange was favoring the knee. And he connected with it, now everybody on the outside, what's Osbourne thinking?
Full head of steam, 300 pounds,
oh my goodness! With no regard for the safety of anyone, Eddie Osbourne flew through the sky. But now back in the ring, the action doesn't stop.
Icarus working on the injured knee of Erik Strange. Erik Strange injured that knee just last year at 22nd anniversary.
Strange hard into the buckle.
Out for 14 months.
And we got Scotty Mac brawling with Eddie Osbourne and Eli Surge on the outside of the ring. As on the inside, Icarus is throwing Strange back and forth from one side of the ring to the other. Oh, big head of steam from Icarus, but
running. Boot.
Both men.
Unbelievable.
I saw it and I still can't believe it.
What a leap from the corner to the outside. Here comes Adonis. Takes Icarus' head off.
They actually
two men that can fly. Yeah. Maybe Adonis is going to fly also. Oh, no, got caught by Icarus.
Icarus
tripped his leg up.
Stopped whatever Adonis had in mind for the outside of the ring. Now Icarus
face to boot.
Oh boy.
Look at that. A transition by Adonis. Russian leg sweep and now running. Star press, nobody home. Watch out for Osbourne. Fireman's carry gonna go for here.
What an opportunist, Eddie Osbourne. I think he just made a low blow.
Oh!
Oh! Connected hard with the referee.
Right to the face of Jeff Hunter, the referee. And another one to Eddie Osbourne. Pump kick by Icarus. Everybody gets a boot.
This one has gone off the rails.
Man, Erik Strange, that knee injury. Watch out for that.
Wait
back.
A minute. The
here
natural
Starr.
Escape. Eli Surge. The award.
Here comes Starr.
Michelle Starr gave a right kick
right
to everybody. Icarus goes down. Surge is
Starr
down. The Natural's
it.
Down.
Natural is out.
Starr
kick. Super kick. Spear. Referee needs to get revived. Erik Strange with a spear. Gets it for victory. Matchup was Beauty and Bills, and Erik Strange picks up the victory with a slight assist from Michelle Starr.
Absolutely incredible action from Bella Bella on this one. The Moonshine Mafia.
The Natural is still down, getting knocked out by Michelle Starr.